I would have loved to start my film about plastic with a helicopter flight. Over nothing but pure, untouched nature. Only, there isn't any untouched nature left on Earth anymore. Once, there was no plastic on planet Earth. But then, in 1907, the Belgian chemist Leo Hendrik van Baekeland turned up. He developed Bakelite, the first completely synthetic product made from petroleum. After the Stone Age, the Bronze Age, and the Ice Age, we now have the Plastic Age. We are the children of the Age of Plastic. I've been surrounded by plastic since birth. I can clearly remember all the bright, lovely, and colourful objects. I know exactly what plastic feels like, how it smells, and above all, how it tastes. In the 60s, my grandfather was managing director of the German Interplastic Works. He taught me to love plastic. And I love to receive his wonderful gifts. Because of them, I was a hero in the neighborhood. My grandfather died when he was 61. I never got the chance to discuss plastic with him. That's why I want to meet John Taylor today, the president of Plastics Europe, the umbrella organization of the European plastics manufacturers. After 18 difficult months of trying to make contact, I finally got this appointment. John Taylor is not only the president of Plastics Europe, he is also the CEO of Borealis, one of the biggest plastics manufacturers in the world.
My name is Bote. I have a Termin with John Taylor.
A wonderful product, wonderful materials.
When I think of my childhood, I always think of plastics, but that's also because of, definitely because of my grandfather.
Mm-hmm.
This was drawn by my grandfather. Mm-hmm. And he pointed out the race of the production. He pointed out that it's 5 million tons a year, and this was for him the proof that there's a big future in it.
Well, this has continued growing. And if you look at it today in Europe, there's something like about 60 million tons.
60 million tons
in Europe, and that's about 25% of the global numbers.
Plastik ist an sich ein Überbegriff jetzt für chemisch unheimliche Vielfalt an Substanzen, die auch auf sehr verschiedene Art und Weise hergestellt werden. Wenn man so will, es ist ein bisschen Lego für Erwachsene. Man nimmt kleine Bausteine und fügt sie zu Dingen zusammen, die nachher Funktionen, Eigenschaften haben, die sie vorher nicht hatten.
This is a high pressure water pipe, but imagine if that was in concrete or metal or steel, it'll be an awful lot heavier. Mm-hmm. There's a bottle here. Again, this is a lightweight material. Mm-hmm. If this was made of glass, it would be a lot heavier. And therefore, if you like, if you want to transport the plastic and move it, you need a lot more energy to take a heavier material. Also, if you drop it, it doesn't break. So there are many aspects where plastics touch into our daily lives.
Use glass and go the hard way. A lot heavier.
Can you imagine life today without plastics? Take an example. Last year was the World Cup for football.
Yeah.
Can you imagine what it would have been like to have the World Cup without plastics?
Well, the ball is made out of leather.
The ball would be made out of leather.
Yeah, no.
It's today made out of plastics, very sophisticated plastics, so they can bend them around the corners more. The clothing.
What about the clothing?
It's also based on plastic materials. Nylons, polyamides, polyesters. What your grandfather started into is today a very vibrant industry, and it'll continue to be for many years to come.
From the Middle Ages down to modern times, the magic of chemistry has fascinated mankind. And to the boy of today, the subject is even more exciting. All around us are the products of modern chemistry. Window shades, draperies, upholstery, and furniture. Chemistry is responsible, too, for the gossamer-like threads of these new stockings. By a miracle of modern science, such commonplace things as coal, water, and air have been transformed into threads more elastic than silk, spun from filaments even finer than those of a spider's web, yet many times as strong.
Das Nylon entsteht an sich als sehr dünne Membran genau an der Grenze zwischen den beiden Flüssigkeiten. Und genau dort, wo die beiden zusammenkommen, entsteht dieser Kunststofffilm, den wir dann rausziehen. Plastikherstellung als solches, wie wir es jetzt hier gemacht haben, ist ungefährlich. Den Rauch, den wir gesehen haben, das waren leichte Dämpfe aus der Reaktionsmischung heraus, die aber an sich dramatischer aussehen, als sie wirklich sind für die Gesundheit. Und es ist so, dass für die Gesundheitsgefährdung jetzt Kunststoffe praktisch vernachlässigbar sind im unmittelbaren Kontakt, weil gesundheitsgefährdend ja grundsätzlich nur etwas ist, was sich löst.
Aren't plastics more of a burden than a solution to modern society?
Do you feel that?
This is the question.
This is the question that some people may be asking. I think one area where plastics do get a bad reputation is in terms of litter. You see plastic bags sitting around.
Yeah.
But who puts the plastics bag there?
Everyone.
We do, as society. Mm. So I think that we take a responsibility there, and we need to train people in society not just to throw bags away.
How are you going to do that?
I think that's a societal issue. I don't think we as a plastics industry, we will do our piece to try and get people to understand the benefit of recycling and working with people down the value chain, but that's something that society's got to look at.
Ça va?
Ça va bien?
Il y a beaucoup de plastique, hein?
Oui, je ne comprends pas les gens. Partout, nous devons ramasser des ordures pour pouvoir commencer avec la mise en scène. C'était comme ça pour les films Gladiator, Star Wars, The Mummy et Le Prince of Persia.
Est-ce qu'il y a un programme de gouvernement?
Mais non, le gouvernement n'a plus d'intérêt, malheureusement.
There are so many studies linking plastic to human health hazards. Are you aware? Did you hear something about this?
There certainly is some commentary, and there's some areas where, again, one has to sort of look very much at the safety of the chemicals that have been used and the after use. This is continuing improvement in terms of the technology. We live in a world that is highly regulated to make sure that we look for the safety of the materials that we, we're going to be using. The alternative, I think we've got to say, is that if we didn't have plastics, what health situations would we be in then?
The plastics industry makes 800 billion euros turnover per year. In Europe alone, more than 1 million people earn their living in the plastics industry. Today, every branch of industry is dependent on plastic. Our life cycle is a plastic cycle.
Es ist so, dass Plastik offiziell ein fast inerter Stoff ist. Man sagt, okay, es sind Problemstoffe in den Kunststoffen drinnen, aber die sind ja da festgebunden und dann kommen weder in natürliche Kreisläufe noch in die Nahrungskette noch in den Menschen. Das stimmt alles nicht. Plastik zerfällt im Laufe der Jahre. Über Hitze, über Abrieb, über Benutzung, über natürlichen Zerfall, diese Moleküle, die ursprünglich gebunden sind, die werden frei. Also Bestandteile von Kunststoffen kann man überall finden. Sie sind ubiquitär, sie sind persistent und vor allem sie haben die fatale Eigenschaft, dass sie sich in Nahrungsketten anreichern können. Und da ist vor allem die große Substanzgruppe der Phthalate zu nennen, weil sie eben massenhaft in Millionen Tonnen jedes Jahr produziert werden. Das Gefährliche an Plastik ist das Schleichende. Ja? Also Plastik zerfällt langsam. Ja? Also Greenpeace hat aufmerksam gemacht, eine PVC-Windel braucht 200 Jahre, bis sie sich in ihre Restbestandteile tatsächlich zerlegt hat. Aber sie hat 200 Jahre die Chance, Problemstoffe in die Umweltmedien abzugeben. Ja? Diese Stoffe kann man immer zurückholen. Und die werden zunehmend eben in die ökologischen Kreisläufe eingehen.
Glauben Sie, dass die Kunststoffindustrie das weiß?
Ja, natürlich. Aber sie verdrängt es ja. Die Verdrängungsleistung der Verantwortlichen ist gigantisch.
Dass wir so viel Plastik im Haus haben.
Ich habe da immer dran gerochen und habe das immer ganz toll gefunden.
Haben Sie was riechen können?
Natürlich.
Dann war es ein schlechter Plastik. Weil ein Plastik, der richtig fest ist, da sollte man eigentlich nichts riechen, weil das, was man riecht, sind üblicherweise Problemstoffe. Weil bei Plastik sollte alles zusammenbleiben, nicht? Wenn Sie was riechen. Das heißt, dass aus dem Plastik spezifische Stoffe an Ihre Nasenschleimhaut gedrungen sind. Und dann war der Plastik eben nicht besonders gut.
Der Plastik ist wirklich nicht der Plastik, wenn das riecht.
Das riecht genau.
My attempt to find out if harmful components are used in plastics leads me to Venice, where PVC was the cause of a human tragedy at the end of the last century.
He was working here. He started working here in 56. He was working in a department where they were making vinyl chloride. And he was working with five colleagues. And they all died of cancer. He was the only one who survived. He had one disease which is caused by vinyl fluoride, which is called Raynaud's disease. And it causes numbing of the extremities, so your feet and your hands would turn white, very pale. You would always feel your hands and feet very cold, which is of course very uncomfortable. And my father believed that there was a connection between vinyl chloride and the illnesses within the company. So he started investigating that. Most workers wouldn't talk to him because they were scared of losing their job. And the trade unions were accusing him of being supported and paid by competitors.
Of the workers who inhaled highly poisonous vapors from PVC production, 170 died of cancer, and another 377 became seriously ill. The only one prepared to take on this case at the time was the notorious prosecutor, Felice Casson.
Per quanto riguarda la pericolosità delle indagini, ero anche abituato, avendo sempre trattato indagini scottanti che riguardavano, ad esempio, i servizi segreti o i traffici d'armi internazionali o il terrorismo anche medio orientale. E quindi ero così un po' anche mentalmente abituato a sopportare il peso di scontri anche fortissimi come quelli contro le multinazionali.
Even though he was a one person going against a huge company, the company was scared of him. And they isolated him also within the company. And they wanted to oblige him to leave the company, but wouldn't fire him, because firing him would mean recognize that what he was saying was true. And so he presented this report to the public prosecutor.
Tutte le aziende multinazionali, comprese la Monte Edison italiana, addirittura avevano sottoscritto un patto di segretezza per cui i dati che parlavano che il CVM era cancerogeno e le ricerche che venivano fatte su questa sostanza cancerogena venivano nascoste, e chi entrava in possesso di queste notizie era vincolato al segreto e firmava proprio un documento patto di segretezza che abbiamo trovato e portato anche al processo.
It turned out afterwards, at the end of the first degree and second degree and then the Supreme Court of Appeal, that he was right. Not only there was an evidence that there was a connection between these illnesses and vinyl chloride, which had been proven also by the World Health Organization, but also that the company knew that these workers were in danger and didn't do anything to protect them. Do you smell it now? Yes, that's horrible. So we're now smelling the air of Marghera.
I want to follow step by step the process from crude oil to the finished product. A simple, but maybe rather naive plan.
Was passiert, wenn man das in den steckt?
Sie werden eine Vergiftung haben. Und Sie werden sich einsperren.
Kann ich reingreifen?
Ja. Sie werden, glaube ich, schwarze Finger haben. Wenn durch ins Blut was reingeht, durch die Haut diffundiert, kann es Blutschädigungen zum Beispiel hervorrufen.
Also ziemlich heftig dann ist das eigentlich.
4% of all black gold is used for the production of plastics. Behind closed doors, crude oil molecules are mixed together with chiefly top secret molecules. And so, a chemical reaction takes place. The molecules arrange themselves in polymer chains. Through a variety of further production processes, plastic pellets are formed. There are thousands of different kinds of pellets for countless requirements. These pellets are often mixed with further top secret additives by the converters, processed, and from this, plastic products are created. We fly into space with plastic. We fulfill our desires with plastic. And even stick plastic inside our bodies.
How are you?
I'm good, and you?
I'm fine. It's a wonderful weather, no?
It is.
Robin. Hi.
Nice to meet you.
Nice meeting you.
The word plastic surgery comes from plastique, which means to mold. So plastic surgeons mold body parts to reconstruct, you know, burns, to reconstruct congenital deformities, and obviously defects created by ablative surgery for cancer procedures or accidents. But, and now, of course, a lot of cosmetic surgery.
Well, you're not 56.
Oh, yes, I am. I'll show you my driver's license.
Yeah, show me. I don't believe you.
Yes,
show me.
You have to.
Show me.
You're terrible.
See?
So I think that's where plastic and the plastique get confused. But of course, within plastic surgery, plastic materials or silicone materials or foreign bodies, so to speak, are used for enhancement purposes.
Excuse me.
All these sort of
should aliens come, you know, visit our planet in the future and dig up grave sites, they're going to wonder what these strange, you know, ornaments that were placed on the bodies over the chest or on the face and what the significance of those were.
Try to concentrate on the plastic in your breasts. Can you concentrate on it?
Yes.
You are concentrated on the plastic in your breasts.
Mm-hmm.
How does it feel?
Like part of me.
It's a part of you?
Yes.
How does it feel?
It's just warm.
Mm-hmm.
Soft like my skin.
Mm-hmm.
Just a part of me.
Witnessing plastic production turns out to be more difficult than I expected.
Jede Person, die das Werk der Borealis in Schwächert betritt, wird bei der Anmeldung registriert. Der Zutritt ist prinzipiell auf einen Tag beschränkt. Beim Betreten von Verfahrensanlagen benötigen Sie Helm, Schutzbrille und Sicherheitsschuhe.
I'm not allowed to see anything. I'm not allowed to film anything. Nowhere am I permitted to look inside. I see pipes. Nothing but pipes.
This alles da is the Erdölraffinerie. And wie geht's dann weiter? Die machen aus dem Gas, habe ich verstanden.
Die machen Erdöl und Gas.
Und ihr kriegt jetzt was?
Wir kriegen Gas. Wir kriegen
nur Gas.
Wir kriegen Gas. Propylen und Ethylen.
Dadurch? Durch die Straßen durch.
Durch die Straßen durch.
Aber wie wird aus einem Gas ein Kunststoff?
Wie über Katalysatoren.
Wir haben zugeliefert.
Ja. Aber zum Beispiel Wasserstoff.
Das macht sie nicht selber.
Nein, das sind Spezialchemikalien.
Genau, das sind die mit den besonderen Namen. Wo man
ja, das sind wo jede Firma ihren eigenen Namen hat und ihre eigenen Geheimnisse. Ja. Und wir testen die aus.
Das heißt, das wisst ihr gar nicht, was das ist. Schon.
Im Detail müssen wir die genaue Beschreibung haben. Weil wir ja wissen müssen, sind da gefährliche Stoffe, sind kanzogene Stoffe drin, ist irgendwas drinnen. Weil wir das für Folien und für Lebensmittel verwenden, das müssen wir sehr wohl wissen. Ja. Also im Detail unser Labor und so, unsere Entwicklungsabteilung.
Ihr habt schon Einsicht in eure Zulieferer.
Absolut.
Weil das hat ja der Konsument wie ich zum Beispiel nicht.
Ja. Und deswegen müssen wir haben, damit wir sicherstellen können, damit zum Konsumenten nichts kommt, was irgendwo nur den Anschein haben könnte, giftig, schädlich oder was auch immer zu sein.
It's even harder to get to film the manufacturing of the end product. 53 well-known international firms denied me permission to film, among them Coca-Cola, Boeing, Mattel. Even more surprising is that the producer of this plastic globe, which you can buy worldwide, actually does invite me. For the first time, I am able to see how this soft elastic film is produced from the pellets.
Hello. My name is Werner Bote. I'm coming to Vicky.
Hello.
Hello.
Nice meeting you. Thank you for inviting us. We can have a look to your company?
Of course.
Because we got this...
Yes.
This bowl.
Today I will show you the procedure of this sample making.
That would be great, yes. Yeah. Do you want me to help you? Ah, look at this. You know what this is? My grandfather did that. My grandfather did a lot of foils.
Our own material factory.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Mm. Smells good.
He said it smells good.
It smells like a peppermint. Chewing gum. You've got a nice job. Do you take them home with you?
Yeah. Many customers have lessons of these items. So mm-hmm. we can make it.
Are you checking every single clove or just everything?
Everything here.
Slowly I realize Madame Tsang doesn't want to show me the plastic film process. Instead, she offers me additives. I feel like I'm dealing on the black market.
We have the six softeners of the material. Mm-hmm. We call it DIMP, DBP, DDP, DINOP, and... I forgot.
Okay.
Yes, you can choose. It's the different price of the uh-huh. different material.
So, for example, if I come to you and I say, make me a globe, 25% DINP.
Yes.
Then you say, well, okay, we can do
yes,
it.
Yes, yes.
But in my country, it's not allowed.
You should double check yeah. if your country yeah. allowed this then.
In spite of the cameras, Madame Tsang takes me for a European client and speaks to me openly about certain company secrets.
But I only want to see how you're doing this foil.
Yes, it's the secret because many other suppliers want to develop this yet.
Mm-hmm.
So it's still a secret.
Mm-hmm.
Not all of the company in Shanghai can make it.
Mm-hmm. Maybe I don't tell anyone. Well,
I
you don't trust
you.
Me because
I
my grandfather
you.
Was in the business.
I believe you, but our boss not allow me to do so.
Yeah, and they might see the film. Because this is for a film which will be shown maybe in a lot in many countries. So
mm-hmm.
It's better not to show you a secret. But what could be a secret? Tell me.
Because
what secret about it?
You know, you will know the chemical consist, and how you will see the producing machine there. So.
Finally, Madame Tsang has obviously figured out that she's dealing with a film crew and cuts off the interview. Maybe now she'll read my request for permission to film. Now I understand that even as a client, I would not have discovered in detail what my product is made of. I find that very strange.
So I think I had introduced our company a lot.
Yeah.
I think you can get to the rough idea.
Yeah.
And you may find some more information in our catalog.
Yeah. I think you talked to your boss on the phone before, and he said, stop talking to them.
Yeah.
Is that what it
yes.
was?
Yes.
Are you drinking out of plastic bottles?
No, thank you.
No?
No.
You don't like plastic?
I don't like water. I like drink.
Whiskey?
Yeah, no.
No?
Okay. Sorry again.
A chemical manufacturer, thousands of miles from here, is producing the plastic. I've heard sometimes it comes in powder forms, it comes in pellet form. It's shipped then to the bottler, who then takes it and use and then converts that into a bottle. It's called extrusion. They're extruding the plastic. This producer over here who bought this does not know what's coming to him from the plastic manufacturer, because that plastic manufacturer is telling him, I've got the best plastic there is. You know, it isn't going to discolor, it isn't going to change the taste of your product, nothing will leach out of it, it's perfectly safe. But it's proprietary, I'm not going to tell you what's in it. So this producer over here has no idea what's in the bottle that he's producing. No one knows what is basically in those plastics that make them better than the other product. But we do know now, because there have been some independent researchers who have gone out and paid chemists in independent laboratories to begin to look, that there are certain chemicals coming out of these bottles. I mentioned fire retardants before. Tributyl tin, a very, very potent androgenic chemical that's in the environment. Basically, it makes whelks, female whelks, grow penises. They found TBT, they found bisphenol A. In a lot of the tests that were done, they found the phthalates. Some plastics have the ability to penetrate the body. They get into the cells in the body. Once you scratch a polycarbonate bottle, the scratching then releases a lot of these monomers, and they do become free.
But it's only when you scratch it? Or...
Well, no, age will scratch it. Heat will do it. Certain detergents, highly alkaline detergent, or even an acidic product in the bottles, will cause those polymers to begin to break, and they look like they're scratched. You know, I'm sure you've, in the old days, we all used what was called in this country Tupperware, and you could always see through it in the beginning. But as it got older, you know, it got really milky looking and scratched up. Certainly those bottles are definitely releasing some of these plastic components.
Haven't you wished for unfillable containers that wouldn't break? I'm here to show you modern dishes for modern living that will save you time and money. There, did you hear it?
Those binoculars are very high impact. You can drop them. They can get wet.
Yeah.
And I'm sure it's because of the plastic components that they put in them. And they're guaranteed for life.
It's good, eh?
Yeah, they're good.
Good stuff.
Very good stuff.
It's starting to rain. We should go, maybe, I think. Is it really that dangerous you're talking about?
I am talking about something that has an effect, a very subtle effect, at the population level. This is a very serious problem. We better start thinking about it, and we better start thinking about it more and more, and start putting some money into doing some research to see if we can find alternatives so that those of us who need to buy our food and purchase our products don't have to purchase products that are not safe.
Ich habe Ihre Weltkugel chemisch analytisch untersucht. Dabei ist herausgekommen, dass wir Metalle gefunden haben, Schwermetalle. Vor allem Quecksilber war zu finden.
Ist giftig.
Ist giftig, ist problematisch und eigentlich in modernen Farbstoffen nicht mehr zulässig. Zudem ist das PVC mit einem Weichmacher versetzt. Diese Phthalate sind seit langen Jahren als gefährliche toxische Substanzen bekannt. Sie wandern aus dem Material im Laufe der Zeit aus, werden dann in der Biosphäre angereichert. Man findet sie in der gesamten Umwelt als belastende Stoffe wieder, werden in der Nahrungskette aufgenommen und können dort zu gesundheitlichen Schäden führen. Zudem haben wir gefunden ausgasende Kohlenwasserstoffe, also leichtflüchtige Substanzen, die reizend wirken auf Atemorgane. Das ist vielleicht auch der leicht scharfe Geruch, den man wahrnehmen kann, als krebserregend eingestuft und sind eigentlich unzulässig.
Das heißt, der Planet ist ziemlich giftig.
Der Planet ist eigentlich als minderwertig und giftig einzustufen.
Was machen wir mit dem Planeten?
Ja, dieser Planet sollte in dieser Form eigentlich gar nicht am Markt sein.
Das heißt, bei diesem Planeten wird immer Schadstoff austreten?
Wird immer austreten, solange bis dieser Erdball porös wird, wenn alle Weichmacher weg sind.
Und dann?
Dann zerbröckelt er. Dann ist er spröde und zerbröckelt.
Once, I used to simply buy a cola in the supermarket. When I stand in front of the shelves today, I suddenly see a bottle made of plastic. Once, I just bought the music I wanted to hear. Now, when I buy a CD, I find I have a plastic disc in my hand. When I've no more use for my products, I throw away the plastic. Every day, 60 kilos a year. The rag pickers on one of the biggest rubbish dumps in the world, collecting plastic to resell it. Because it can be used again. Nevertheless, plastic is the least valuable material here. On this dump here, you earn the least with plastic. The rag pickers sell what they've collected by weight. That's why there's a hierarchy among them. The established ones collect metal, wood, glass, and other heavy materials. What remains for the poorest of the poor is only the lighter plastic. If industry paid more for plastic waste, we would care about plastic a lot more. Then we wouldn't be so quick to simply throw away our unwanted plastic.
And this is all the plastic shit that I found in my house.
This is the debris that was taken from the bellies of four baby albatross chicks that were found dead on Midway Island. The parent birds fly into the North Pacific, and all of this plastic debris stays on the surface of the ocean. And they pick it up and they bring it back and then regurgitate into the baby. They perforate the stomach, and then the babies die.
Plastic chairs. Of course.
Okay. It's a plastic planet.
Yeah. Is it a plastic planet?
Yeah.
Why do you think so?
Because there's a layer of plastic over the entire planet.
A layer of plastic?
Well, these small particles are coating the surface of the Earth.
Yeah.
They're blown by the wind, they're moved by the sea, deposited on land and on the bottom of the ocean. I first discovered the extent of the plastic pollution of the ocean in 1997, where we had a 6-to-1 ratio in 1999. Now if we went out to the area of highest accumulation, we could find 60-to-1 plastic to plankton.
60-to-1 plastic to plankton.
Most anywhere in the Earth, they will find plastic in the future because it won't biodegrade and it'll be in the sample.
If you're looking now to the sea, it looks quite nice.
You can't expect to see something on top of a liquid. Something that is got any weight at all will sink in a liquid. So when you see the surface of the sea only floats, and large, lightweight objects will stay above the surface of the ocean. What you have to do to see the plastic is stand on the side of the vessel or on the bow of the vessel, look down into the water. We'll continue trawling for 15 minutes and then we'll retrieve the trawl. And we can do it again if you like. Still no contact from me. Yeah, let's go until 5 minutes till we'll keep this one.
Plastic there.
Well, we'd have to look at this at the laboratory to let it go. That's just one sample. So.
This is what Captain Moore trawled out of the sea. Fish take the corroded plastic for plankton and eat it until they're full. They end up with a belly full of plastic.
The detritus of civilization has now polluted the deep ocean. There's no taking it back. You can't get it out. No one can clean that up.
And it's getting more and more.
There's one.
Oh, yes.
Got it.
Yep. Yeah, nice roach there.
Hey.
There we go, it's a nice roach there.
A roach?
Yep.
Nice
one.
Have
Have you been always interested in fish?
I have always been interested in fish, actually.
How come?
From being a child.
Oh, yeah?
I was always interested in the sea, what was under the sea.
Yeah.
And I wanted to be a marine zoologist and go and dive on the Barrier Reef.
Yeah.
But I ended up working on pollution and its effects on fish.
Okay.
Not so glamorous.
Why not?
Because it's on rivers like this rather than on the Barrier Reef.
Well, it's a nice river, surrounded by industry.
This is a section sliced through the gonad.
Mm-hmm.
Of a female fish, and the male looks completely different, as you can see. This is an intersex fish, so what you should be able to see is you can't see any of the large eggs, the large developing eggs that we saw in the female, but you can see the small ones. So these small circular structures are all oocytes, or
so
developing eggs, and these are sperm.
From everything.
Yeah. The impact of the finding of intersex fish in rivers and of sewage effluents with estrogenic things in them that we didn't know what they were, that was what led to the discovery that things like phthalates and bisphenol A were endocrine disruptors. They were they could cause effects on the endocrine system.
On the shores of the island of nature, I think about my grandfather. I would gladly go walking with him here, amongst the plastic garbage washed up by the sea. I'd like to find out what he'd think about the material which used to fascinate him so, if he could see it here.
Welcome. Annyeonghaseyo. Annyeonghaseyo.
Hi,
how are you? Welcome on the islands of nature. Are you coming to help us cleaning up?
Yeah.
Yeah? that's cool.
Once a year, a clean-up event is organized on Japan's island of nature. The rubbish that gathers here year after year comes from ships or drifts over from Korea.
Singapore is also plastic.
200 Korean students, 100 Japanese volunteers, and this time, me, take up arms against the plastic waste.
Korea?
Oh, Korea!
In 2 days, we have filled 120 trucks, but nobody wants to take the rubbish, as it is every year. It's just too much for the rubbish dump on the island. In the end, the town of Fukuoka agrees to take the rubbish.
Everybody,
Should I be proud of what we've done? This is just one little bay on one Japanese island. Japan has over 6,000 islands. Plus the fact that next year we'll have to organize another cleanup event. The big ships will again dump their waste into the bay, and the sea will have again carried plastic over from Korea.
Asking myself all the time the question, is plastic now dangerous or is it not? And I thought you are the one who can help me a little bit in this.
I would say I can't answer that question.
Why not?
Because my investigations are much more specific than the question. So that you asked, because plastics, not plastics, not plastic. You know, my research is focused on a single or a very few types of components that go into plastic.
Especially BPA.
Bisphenol A, which is
in all the plastic bottles.
Well, it's the polymer of the polycarbonate plastic, okay. And it's also used in the application for coatings and preservatives in rubber and other kinds of plastic. So it's one that's a big industrial chemical that's out big in the sense that I mean that there's a lot of it.
The American scientist, Patricia Hunt, did studies which had nothing at all to do with plastic.
More rats?
Until she stumbled over it.
So we used these cages over and over and over again. For years we used the cages, they were fine. And then suddenly we had this change in our data where our control animals started to show us very strange eggs. And we were trying to figure out what was going on, what caused this change. The cages were damaged by one wash, the wrong detergent, and that meant the plastic started to degrade. Mm-hmm. So what does this mean to us? It means that plastics that we use that contain this bisphenol A, the polycarbonate plastics, baby bottles, many of those are polycarbonate, that with repeated use and wash and high temperatures, eventually the plastic will start to degrade, mm-hmm. and eventually they'll start to leach more and more of this chemical.
We've shown that if you put water in it, and others have shown it, in polycarbonate plastic, the bisphenol A is released, especially upon heating, if you heat it up.
We eat it, we drink it, we get it passed through our skin. This chemical mimics a hormone, and hormones they send signals and tell cells to do things. And so those signals sent at the wrong time or in the wrong amount to the fetus can change how that fetus develops. And when you stop and think about it, it's really interesting because it means the pregnant female is allowing this chemical to simultaneously touch three generations, the mother who's exposed, the fetus, and if she's a female fetus, all of her eggs, which will be effectively the grandchildren.
And bisphenol A can cause
cell death.
Yeah.
It's changing how our normal hormones are working. Bisphenol A is a chemical that acts like estrogen. Estrogen affects how our brains develop, and changing that estrogen-like activity in the brain, especially while your brain's maturing, can change how your brain functions later in life.
We're used to thinking about toxins as the amount you receive dictates how much damage is going to be done. So more is worse. And in this case, with something that acts like a hormone, that's not true. Hormones act at very, very low levels. Just a little sniff will cause cells to go crazy. So in this case, it's asking questions about how very low levels of a chemical might impact a cell.
Mm-mm.
Is plastic our golem? Has the wonderful invention turned against its creator? In 1999, the plastics industry alleged in an official declaration that bisphenol A is harmless. After decades of use worldwide and hundreds of independent studies, the dangers of bisphenol A have been proven. Not to mention nonylphenol, softeners, phthalates, flame retardants, tributyl tin, mercury, etc., etc. I'm worried that poison is running continually through my bloodstream.
Apparat, Knochen, Knorpel und alle großen Gefäße hier mit Silikonkautschuk, damit sie flexibel bleiben, damit sie nicht brechen, ja?
Ja.
Die wurden zusätzlich injiziert, mit Enzymen freigestellt, Lunge entfernt und so sind wir zu diesem Apparat gekommen.
Das heißt, er hat schon sehr viel Kunststoff im Blut.
Das ist ein Silikonbändermensch.
Günther von Hagens plastinizes bodies for eternity. It's the modern form of mummification.
Das ist der Kunststoff, schön dünn, lange Verarbeitungszeit, wird injiziert.
Was ist das für ein Kunststoff?
Das ist ein Spezial-Epoxidharz. Epoxidharz, wie er im Flugzeugbau verwendet wird,
ja.
Mit einer Verarbeitungszeit von 4 Stunden, wie wir fertig ist. Das Baby beginnt mit dem Silikon am Schnuller. Ja? Und wir enden mit Silikon als Plastinat. Ist das nicht der Kunststofflebensweg des modernen Menschen?
Ihre Aufmerksamkeit.
I'm starting to get the feeling that I'm eating plastics. I feel I'm losing the ability to distinguish between food and the plastic decorations in Japanese restaurants.
You don't like plastic?
No.
Why not? Ah, this is plastic.
Oh.
This is plastic?
No, this is not plastic. It's a cart. Glass.
Mirror. It's glass?
Yes.
It's plastic.
No.
Sure?
Confident.
This is plastic. For the baby.
For water.
Water? Everything.
The plastic, the actually, because it's good business. When you go to Kenya or the outside the Dubai, I get them like about for the best thing, like this one is 15,000 or 20. When I came, I say about 22, 11, 21, like that. So I get a property. That's why I'm okay to my work now. So everything, my business, I have my customer, everybody come to my shop. Some people like it, you buy it, then you go next time because it happened, next time you're coming back again.
The amount of plastic we've produced since the beginning of the plastic age is enough to wrap the entire planet in plastic bags six times over. Plastic surrounds us like an invisible shell. Every attempt at resistance seems hopeless. Congratulations, grandfather. Your plastic is invincible.
他にも別の素材を使うこともあります。で、今この粘土がやっぱその、これをあまり言うとあれかもしれないんですけども、実際に亡くなってる友達もいてるんですよ。
先ほど換気気をつけたりとかはしてるんですけども、でもですかね、そのあんまり良くはないと思ってます。プラスチックペルナス。わあ。Unbelievable.
When you get in the car and it's hot and there's film on the window, you are breathing in huge amounts of off-gassing phthalate. And when enough of that chemical has off-gassed, what happens to the plastic dashboard and your plastic seats? They crack and they disintegrate. And what are those phthalates doing to you? They are suppressing your testosterone. They are reducing your sperm production. They are stimulating body weight increase. They are changing all kinds of aspects of your physiology in bad ways.
And you have a good vein, so this should be easy to do. And then we fortunately just have a metal needle on. Mm-hmm. And then this is where the blood comes out. Mm-hmm. And all these are glass vials mm-hmm. with the plastic, so.
Well, they will find out in Missouri mm-hmm. how many bisphenol A I'm having in my blood, right. So.
So, welcome in. In the fluid part of the blood, you have measurable levels of bisphenol A. The amount that you have in your body in an animal is enough to reduce the amount of sperm that is made in the testes by about 40%. So it's not just that you're infertile. You are unfortunately fertile enough to produce an abnormal baby. Anything stored in a polycarbonate container will contain bisphenol A, 100%. It is certain, it is an indirect food additive. Anything stored in bisphenol A should have bisphenol A listed as a component of the food you are eating. What's the difference between what is put in by the food processor or what is put in as a result of the food packager? If you can legally create a situation where the food processor must tell you, why can't you create a situation where the food packager must tell you? The food packager in the United States happens to be the biggest chemical companies in the world, General Electric, Dow Chemical, Shell Oil for many years, Bayer, Mitsubishi. These are very, very powerful corporations, and they have tremendous power over politicians.
And did you ever talk to the industry about it?
You know, when I first realized what was going on, I actually got in touch with someone from industry because I thought, well, they should want to know this. They should be interested in funding these studies. And they sent me a stack of papers to read, and I told them, you know, I really wanted to be very conservative because what we would publish would be that exposure to low levels of this chemical mm-hmm. could cause miscarriages. Mm-hmm. And before I did that, I wanted to make sure that we were really, had really yeah. tested yeah. this carefully. And they said, oh, that's good. We're glad you're being very cautious. Yeah. And no interest in, you know, trying to support the studies or, you know, mm-hmm. provide guidance.
I would say that at this time, we cannot state that there is any safe plastic.
You're still alive?
That's a very good point. These chemicals do not kill you. They just harm your quality of life. They give you asthma. They lead to obesity. They lead to brain disorders.
On the other hand, all those materials help me to stay alive as well. When I'm going to the hospital, everything is made out of plastic.
On your way to the hospital for chemotherapy and radiation therapy for the cancer caused by these chemicals, you ask yourself, have they really improved the quality of the life I am living? That's the question.
I now feel enlightened enough to confront John Taylor, the president of Plastics Europe, once again. I want him to stop using harmful substances in plastic production. When he made it clear he had no time for me, I decided to go and find him at the International Plastics Fair. So I brought along all 700 studies I've collected on the subject of plastic, which show clear evidence of the dangers of plastic.
Female wilts, grow penises. ADHD.
More female babies than male babies.
Autism. Childhood diabetes.
No, next generation.
Juvenile delinquency.
Cause these cells to die.
Childhood arthritis.
There's more plastic than plankton.
Early testicular cancer.
But I've also got 10 studies which contest all the accusations. They are studies funded by the multinationals. But plastic is seductive. I've hardly entered the exhibition hall when I feel my grandfather next to me.
It's good.
He shows me all the wonderful cars, motorbikes, and rockets. A real dilemma.
Plastics protects you whatever you do, wherever you go. Plastics, it's in our everyday life.
Should I really let myself be so naively pleased? But grandfather didn't only teach me to love plastic, he also taught me to use my brains. To give myself strength, I take a deep drag on his beloved material. Then, stoned on the smell of softener, I go in search of John Taylor.
Mr. Taylor, please, you said
we don't want you on the stand.
I have a question. You want us to be the ambassador for plastics? And I want to know how.
I'm having 700 studies. They prove the dangers of plastics. Mr. Taylor.
It's very difficult to get in. 700 studies, scientific studies.
And would you like to please leave?
I'm not going to be embarrassed. I just want to. Because it's a serious subject.
I think there are
700 different scientific studies and really very heavy studies. Well done.
I think it's not that these are not serious. It's just that we have a very short period of time to be at the fair, and but our focus is to focus on this.
Yeah.
And if we can arrange a meeting, this would be fine.
Okay.
Is this all right for you?
What do you think about? Okay. Do you think about next week or next year?
I will give you a call.
Okay.
I commit myself to giving you a call.
That's nice.
Okay.
That's nice. Thanks.
Plastics are already nachfahren. Did you know that? Hast du gewusst, dass du unfassbar wirst durch Plastik? Hast du das schon mal gehört? Kannst du das den Allergien hervorrufen? Habt ihr gewusst, dass es 500 Jahre...
Did you know that we're all treated by the industry like laboratory rabbits? Did you know that the entire planet is poisoned? Did you know that the industry refuses to take dangerous materials off the market? Am I the only one who cares about plastic? Since the industrialization of plastics, meaning within the last 50 years, human sperm production has diminished by 53%. To find out if this has something to do with plastics, I commissioned a study of sterile couples. It has long since been proved that everyone has plastic in the blood, even the Inuit and the Amazon Indians. This study is trying to discover whether sterile couples have more milligrams per kilo of plastic in the blood plasma than all the others.
Das ist weltweit sicher einer der ersten Tests am Menschen, ist es wahrscheinlich der erste Test. Es gibt also bei Rattenversuche, dass der Hoden kleiner wird und die Gebärmutter größer. Warum? Weil das wirkt wie das Hormon Östrogen. Mhm.
Und dementsprechend schaut das so aus, dass beide von ihnen leider Gottes eine sehr hohe Belastung mit der Kunststoff haben.
Das heißt, sie haben viel
Phthalat. Ein bisschen mehr Phthalat.
Ja.
Ein bisschen zu viel Tapper.
Naja.
Das heißt, ich soll noch diesen Nonylphenol ausschalten.
Nonylphenol ist, also das ist bei dem Ergebnis rausgekommen.
Hat der so viel Kunststoff zu Hause?
Anscheinend.
Ja, also nicht bewusst.
Mhm.
Also es ist mir ja nicht bewusst, ich gehe ja nicht in ein Geschäft hinein und wähle mir die ungesündesten Artikel aus sozusagen, sondern ich kaufe das noch, was mir ist.
Jetzt in seinem Fall, weil er also verhältnismäßig viel Phthalate hat, da könnte man zum Beispiel weniger PVC-Produkte kaufen.
PVC is number 3 in the plastic recycling code. Bisphenol A stands at 7. Each group has its own problems. Most of the additives are unknown.
Industry is not going to change the composition of their baby bottles because my study came out saying that maybe exposures interfere with our ability to make eggs. But they are going to change if consumers say, I don't want to buy that bottle because I'm not buying a bottle that has bisphenol A in it. My baby won't drink out of that. And so one of the things that I raised as an issue is I'm concerned about the fact that these plastics, like baby bottles, are made of polycarbonate. And I got a call from one of the baby bottle manufacturers. What's going on there? We get all these calls from parents wanting to know, what is this bottle made out of?
I'm now going to confront the packaging manager of a supermarket with the question, what is this bottle made out of?
What is that for short plastic?
Dit zou ook gewoon een polyethyleen zijn, maar ik denk niet dat het hierop vermeld staat. Maar het is wel een polyethyleen met een speciale coating waarschijnlijk. Hè? Nee, het staat er niet direct op vermeld. Op deze staat het niet vermeld. Ik weet niet of het op onze tubes vermeld staat. Hier staat het niet vermeld. In elk geval, de basis zal zeker polyethyleen zijn. Maar er zal natuurlijk nog wel een coating... Nee, hier toch ook niet. Hè? Nee, hier wordt het niet vermeld. Nee. Iedereen weet dat petroleum, dat plastic van petroleum afkomstig is. Petroleum wordt schaarster, wordt duurder. En automatisch ga je dan toch zoeken naar alternatieven. Daar waar het kan.
Zoals? Dus, zijn er alternatieven?
Ja, alternatieven onder de vorm van verpakkingsmateriaal die afkomstig zijn van hernieuwbare grondstof, plantaardige grondstoffen, bioplastics genoemd in de volksmond. Misschien niet zo'n
heel goede term. Heeft u hier zoiets?
We hebben hier bioplastics in onze winkels, in de vleesafdeling. Dus deze producten hier.
Dit hier? Die,
gehakt.
Dus de gehakte, de droge vleesproducten, die zijn verpakt in een materiaal dat afkomstig is van...
Bijvoorbeeld niet de Amerikaan, omdat dat te vochtig is.
Die zijn verpakt in een schaal die afkomstig is van suikerrietvezel.
Dit is suikerriet?
Ja.
Afval van suikerriet.
Afval
maar
van
zou suikerriet. Het niet leuk zijn voor mij als klant om te weten dat dit iets anders is dan deze?
Staat erop.
Deze. Staat al?
Ja,
waar
ja,
staat het dan?
Het staat hier.
Dit bio-packaging.
Ja, ja. Ah, ja. Dus hier heb je een vermelding dat het plantaardig is.
Het slaat wel op het pakketje, ook... op het schaaltje.
En dat op het schaaltje. Niet de plastic.
Het is niet
morsig. Bioplastic sounds healthy. But when I have 6 biodegradable end products analyzed, it turns out that one containing 28 milligrams of carcinogenic DINP was poisonous. And of all the things, the beloved children's toy, Happy Maze. The other 5 products showed no evidence of known toxins. The Novamont company produces biodegradable plastics and searches for new raw materials.
This is the gold of the future. This is the plastic of the future.
Okay.
This is the future. This is Materbee, which is a compostable material which includes starch in this case, may include vegetable oils and some other polymers in order to process it. It's really the alternative to non-given raw materials like crude oil. And we really need to find alternatives. And in this case, we're able to find these alternatives working together with farmers.
Yeah.
Because farmers nowadays are more industrial, so they're not anymore just producers of...
It's nice.
Well, you look much better now. So maybe we should sell it to some brand owners selling
it's like
cosmetics.
Food. It smells like food.
It smells like food. It is very soft.
It doesn't have anything to do with plastic anymore. I'm very surprised. This is not Materbee. This is polystyrene.
And you are right.
And this one is here, PET.
Yes.
Why are you not? You cannot do this with compostable plastic.
No, no, we can, but we finished. Sorry.
You finished. You don't have enough.
We didn't have enough. The
sometimes we finish our own material, and then we have to go on traditional ones instead of using. So this is paper cups, which are laminated.
It's paper laminated with Materbee inside.
Inside with the polymer.
We can use properly the biomass, but we can use also in a way which is dramatically damaging all the world. So, like look at biodiesel or bioethanol. We cannot take all the food crops and to transform in energy, because from one problem we create another problem. In the case of biodegradables, we are just at the beginning. The total volume today is not higher than 200,000 tons, more or less. And we cover about 60,000 as a capacity. And so we have a quite significant share at this moment. Mm-hmm. But it's still 0-something% of traditional plastics.
This is what happened after 15 days in a composting plant, after 21 days and after 45 days. And it's a thick part as well. So you can see this is the result of what happens with a biodegradable and compostable polymer.
It's no longer simply a question of plastic being a fascinating or dangerous material. Plastic is a complete cycle. Even if, from today on, we only used harmless plastic, we would still have to carry around traditional plastic with all its toxins for about 500 years. Will there still be life on our planet then? old plastic will be either burned with household refuse or recycled. They say that the toxins will be filtered out during burning. Then the dirty filters will be buried underground. With recycling, there's the problem that nobody has any idea which chemicals were used during manufacture. They say that only inferior plastic is being produced from the recycled material. Waste pipes, for example. The sewage runs through, the poisons leak out and enter the environment once more. Plastic. The invisible danger. Finally, Plastics Europe knocked on my door. The reaction to my claims promised at the Plastics Fair. They arrive in the guise of a trained business speaker who also works for oil companies, Mr. Ray Hammond.
Good, thank you. I got a call from some people in Plastics Europe.
Yeah.
Who said that a film was being made.
Okay.
And as you probably know, I've just written a book called The World in 2030.
Yeah.
In which plastics plays an important part. But they suggested that I should come to Vienna to talk to you. And they said to me, I think you might want to talk a bit about the future.
So what's the word for plastic in the future?
It's going to change. It's going to change dramatically. Mm-hmm. From being an inert substance, mm-hmm. it's going to become smart, mm-hmm. even sentient, even cognitive. It's going to become very smart. It's going to know when food has gone bad. Yeah. It's going to know where it is in the world at all times. Mm-hmm. It's going to become self-healing. So it can be used in things like spacecraft, where it will automatically repair itself if damaged. It's going to be capable of sending out signals that change its own shape. Mm-hmm. So a surgeon might put a piece of plastic mm-hmm. into your artery or into your vein, and by shining a light on it, can cause it to open and then and open your vein.
I think that you came across the human health hazards concerning plastics.
I came across suggestions that there are chemicals in plastics which can affect the human endocrine systems. In other
for
words,
example.
For example. Now, I was very concerned with this, and I looked at it in detail, and I found out that in the year 2007, the European Food Safety Administration dismissed all such fears. Then if they say it's okay, I have to accept that. I have to accept that. Mm. They are far more rigorous than America's FDA.
Yeah.
I think the plastics industry in Europe, mm-hmm. they realise for their future, they have to be good corporate citizens. In other words, they must show responsibility in the way they grow and develop their products and work with society.
So you think they're taking care?
No, I don't know whether they are or whether they're not. Mm-hmm. What I do know is that they're saying they intend to, which is something quite different.
Do you know one product which is made out of plastic, which you have maybe at home? I'm sure you have in plastic at home. You have plastic at home?
Of course.
Do you know one? Just one item, and you know what is in it?
No.
You have no idea about it.
And why don't I?
Because you trust.
Yes. I trust it.
My grandfather was working for this industry for many years.
But he probably didn't have a clue about anything like this.
I don't know.
He would have known probably that the vinyl chloride monomer was a carcinogen. For the people who work in the plant, in the big vats and stuff, working with it, cleaning it and stuff, there was evidence that they were at risk, but not, we did not know how dangerous the final products were until after 1990. He would not have known that. That's a very recent finding.
The EU REACH program is the strictest chemical legislation in the world. The Vice President of the European Commission, Margot Wollström, was responsible for this program as Environment Commissioner. I bring her a nice present, a lovely and colorful globe bought in Vienna.
It's a plastic planet.
This is, it's in everything. It's in our food, mm-hmm. It's in our shoes, it's in our clothes, it's in our cars, in everything. We know about the increasing rate of an incidence of allergies, cancer, all these problems with
endocrine disruptions.
Yes, absolutely. Mm. So hormone disrupting substances. So this is not. This is already a scientific fact. You know that during 10 years we were able to have a risk assessment for 11 substances. Out of the 100,000 substances that we ought to check on. Mm-hmm. This took us 10 years and we checked on 11 substances. And of course, this is a system that doesn't work. And as long as we don't know, as long as we don't have the full information, of course, also industry can say, well, you cannot prove that this is dangerous, so we can continue to produce it or you can use it. Until now, it has been for the authorities, for society to prove that something is dangerous. It should be the other way around. It has to be for the producers mm-hmm. to demonstrate that what they make and sell is not dangerous. Of course, we want to have a user-safe label. The industry did some heavy lobbying towards the commission, and they were often very aggressive, and I just felt aggressive that it was very old-fashioned. It was an industry that has been, I think, that has been almost too powerful over the years.
Was there pressure from other countries?
Yes,
for
definitely.
Example, can you tell
well,
me
from
about?
The United States, there was a heavy pressure from the United States. They were afraid that this would also mean that American producers would, of course, have to follow the same rules as the Europeans, and they didn't like it. I expect more from the chemicals industry as well. I think they should go to join forces as well and show that they are progressive, that they are thinking about the future as well.
My grandfather died much too early. He simply did not know about the dangers of plastics. But today, we know better.
Ich bin froh, dass am Grab vom Opa keine Plastikblumen mehr stehen.
Die habe ich ja weggegeben.
Warum hast du die weggegeben?
Weil es mir nicht gefallen wird. Flieder vom Garten gefällt mir besser.
Warum?
Na ja, solange er frisch ist, wenn der Flieder blüht.
Mama, ich bin stolz auf dich.
We'll be right back.